Let's take a look at two examples of adding and subtracting polynomials. Notice the first example, we're adding polynomials. And when we're adding polynomials, we can just eliminate the parentheses and then combine like terms. But if it's helpful, we could think of putting a 1 here and a 1 here and then distributing a positive 1. But we know if we multiply something by positive 1, it's not going to change anything. So we would have 2x to the fifth minus 6x to the third minus 12x squared minus 4. And then again here we're multiplying by a positive 1, so we're going to have minus 11x to the fifth plus 8x plus 2x squared plus 6. Again, notice how when adding polynomials, we can just go ahead and eliminate the parentheses. Now we'll identify the like terms. Here we have 2x to the fifth terms. We don't have any x to the fourth terms, and we only have 1x to the third term, but we do have 2x squared terms, one here and one here. We only have 1x term, but we do have two constants, here and here. Now we'll combine terms starting with the highest degree. So looking at the x to the fifth terms, for 2x to the fifth minus 11x to the fifth, since 2 minus 11 is negative 9, we'll have negative 9x to the fifth. So we've combined those two. But there aren't any x to the fourth terms, but there is 1x to the third term, so we have minus 6x to the third. And there are 2x squared terms. We have negative 12x squared plus 2x squared. Well, negative 12 plus 2 is negative 10, so we'd have negative 10x squared. But instead of writing plus negative 10x squared, we'll write minus 10x squared, which is equivalent. So those have been combined. And then we have our x term, so we have plus 8x. And the last two are the constants. Here we have negative 4 plus 6, which is positive 2. So we have plus 2. Now we're going to do the same thing on our subtraction problem here. We're going to clear the parentheses so we can think of distributing a positive 1 here. But because we're subtracting this entire polynomial, if we put a 1 here, we're going to distribute a negative 1. We're just going to change the sign of every term. So first we'll have negative 9y to the third minus 6y squared minus 11x plus 2. But then when we distribute a negative 1, we're going to have negative 1 times negative 9y to the 4th. That'll be plus 9y to the 4th. And then we have a negative 1 times a negative 8y cubed. That'll be plus 8y cubed. Then we have a negative times a positive. So that'll be minus 4x squared. And then a negative times a positive. So I'll have minus 2x. Notice that every sign in the polynomial that we were subtracting has been changed because we distributed the minus or negative 1. Now we'll combine like terms. Notice how there's only 1y to the fourth term. Well, here are 2y to the third terms. Now this is a y squared and this is an x squared, so those are not like terms. There are 2x terms here and here. And that looks like all that we can combine. We do want to write this in descending order, so we'll start with the highest degree terms first, which would be 9y to the fourth. Then we have y cubed terms. We have negative 9y cubed plus 8y cubed. Well, negative 9 plus 8 is negative 1, so we'll have negative 1y cubed, or just minus y cubed. So we've combined these two. And then we have 2 degree 2 terms. One's a y squared term and one's an x squared term. Let's go ahead and write this minus 6y squared minus 4x squared. So we've taken care of those two terms. And now we have 2x terms, negative 11x minus 2x. That's negative 11 minus 2 is negative 13. We'll have minus 13x. And then finally we have the constant of plus 2. So this is a good example of identifying like terms, meaning the variable parts must be exactly the same with the same variables.